Question time will again come from London, and we're keeping the panel up our sleeve until we know the name of the next Prime Minister, which of course we will do by then. So that's question time next Thursday at 10 o'clock on BBC One. Breakfast News is on air later this morning, half an hour early at 6 o'clock. Thank you for watching, and to you all, a very good night.
Highlights of the first day's play in the first test, tomorrow at 7.15 on BBC Two.
If you want to hear live commentary on the match, it's already underway on Radio 3 Medium Wave and continues right through until 7 o'clock in the morning. And talking of through the night radio, our friends in Radio 2 are well into their 24-hour Children in Need marathon. Ken Bruce is in the hot seat, and we've sneaked a camera in so that we can get a progress report from the man of the moment.
And you join us at a very important time here in the beautiful splendour of Studio B9 in Broadcasting House. We are reaching the end of the sixth hour of our 24-hour marathon here on Radio 2, playing the music that you're requesting in return for a pledge for children in need. Now, the number to phone in on is 071-580-4411. You can phone in any time between now and 7 p.m. tonight. Friday night. Now, at the moment, our money has reached, I think, well, we're getting towards the £300,000 mark, so it's going very well so far. It can go higher, so if you would like to phone in and ask for a piece of music, we'll do our best to play it for you, provided you do your best to pledge some money for children in need. Remember that number, 071-580-4411. We'll be going right through until 7 p.m. Friday night. John Dunn will be on the air at that point, and then he'll be joining all of us on television, where I'll be counting the money, to tell us how much Radio 2 has raised over the previous 24 hours. Make it a good total by phoning in. The number once more is 071-580-4411.
Well, thanks, Ken. We look forward to seeing you again when BBC One takes off for a night of fantastic fun and fanatical fundraising in a few hours' time. As the man said, it begins tomorrow, Friday evening at 7 o'clock. A look at the weather now. Fog and frost will be widespread at first tonight, but it'll tend to lift in western areas to be replaced by wind and rain. Much of England and the eastern half of Wales will start Friday with fog and patchy frost, and in eastern areas especially, the fog could well be slow to clear. Northern Ireland and western Scotland are expected to begin the day with persistent and sometimes heavy rain accompanied by a driving southerly wind. This wet and windy weather will spread eastwards, and by evening seems likely to have reached much of Scotland, Wales and western parts of England. Snow is expected over high ground. During the afternoon, Northern Ireland and western Scotland will probably become brighter, although showery. It's going to feel quite raw in the wet areas, but western parts will turn milder later in the day. Well, that's it for tonight. Ken Bruce has already invited you to move across to Radio 2, but please do come back to BBC One for Children in Need with Terry Wogan, Sue Cook and a galaxy of stars. It's going to be a great night. Now, on behalf of everybody here, this is Malcolm Eynon wishing you a peaceful Thursday night and a pleasant day, and we'll see you soon. Good night.